And here we are again, guys, with another of my presentation. This is Paolo here, Logitech Forte MotorWorks. And today I wanted to present you an item that I made. I guess it was also this 3 or 4 years ago now. Friends can correct me if I'm wrong. And I start this time showing you already the finished model, because this was a very particular item that I wanted to produce. It was the final evolution of the Lancia Delta Evoluzione, and it was the racing family of the Lancia. So everything started with the Lancia Delta S4 and the Group B racers racing in 1986. You know, said this car was the final evolution, named ACV2, where ACV2 means Experimental Composite Vehicle Number 2. So it was the second version of this type of vehicles, and it was produced by Lancia in 1988, if I'm not wrong, like a final evolution of the deadly Group B. That should be the Group S, they called it, where the big guys should enter in the game, like Porsche, like Ferrari, with the 288 GTO and the 959 Porsche, and so on. They were all belonging to the same category, but the group have been cancelled before they even started, because the powerful and the danger of the racing, of the rally racing, became too much, and they had a lot of deadly crashes, you know, much better than me. I'm referring to Toivonen crash and to the Ford RS200 crash in Portugal. So there have been a lot of talk, and they canceled completely the category, and they restarted from the A group in 1987, I guess, if I'm not wrong, you know. So these models that were really developed by Lancia was never used during racing. So they ended up just modifying the original S4 into the ACV, where mostly the internal frame of the car was completely different, because it was not any longer made like a space frame tubular chassis, like anyway the original Lancia S4 was, but this was completely made in a monocoque carbon fiber, completely made in carbon fiber, composite materials, you know, the beginning of the composite materials. And this little racer claimed, because she never proved it in reality, claimed an enormous powerful, you know, they were talking like numbers of 600 horsepower, and with a board that can be modified, it can reach even more, and the weight was absolutely under, I think it was around 800 kilos, something like that. So it was a deadly machine. And nobody knew if in reality this car can be so competitive and so powerful like they write on the numbers. You know, we have to remember that it was the late 80s, so the technology was anyway extreme, and becoming too dangerous mostly, you know. The model that I wanted to produce at the time, it was just around this vehicle. I'm also preparing the ACV1. That was a little more famous than this one, because it was the red Lancia Delta S4 Evoluzione, and it is still in the master area. I mean, I still didn't finish it. I made a body shell that is complete, and some people have seen that in forum, in internet, in Facebook, all over. But I just finished the external body shell, and I miss, because in the beginning I just wanted to make them like a kind of trans kit for rare racing kit. That it was quite optimistic, you know, because the only kit that existed when I produced this car, it was the Modeler Delta S4, and I think the Profil 24 racing kit of the Delta S4. So it was a little probably pretentious to make a trans kit about something that was already so rare. So I wanted to stop a little that program, unless recently Aoshima B-Max made a very nice Delta S4 in plastic, that I think all the guys liking cars and like these racers have taken it, of course, like I did. And I wanted to adapt that body that was made in the original to fit over this kind of racing kits to the plastic of B-Max. So that's why the trans kit is little in standby right now, because I have other projects going on. I started with trucks, and I have a big commitment. You know, I produce models under request mostly, so all the stuff that I present you, that I introduce you, is something that I do in my spare time. It is not the stuff that I do like a pro modeler, you know. And The ACV1, then it's in standby, and I hope really soon to finish it because the body shell is done, the decal sheet is done, everything is nearly ready. You know, I just have to make it in a proper way to keep it decent and to keep it nice for the lovers of this racer. Many guys write me, "Hey Paolo, what about the production of the ACV1? Are you going to make it?" Yes, I'm going absolutely to make it, but probably not right now, not in this moment. It can be the next year, it can be in 2 years, because the model is anyway done. So I can absolutely cast it in racing and made it, and the decals. Andrew Zed made an incredible, nice work with the livery. He's an incredibly skilled guy making decals. So the main parts are done. I just miss the final part. So you had to keep patents about that. This was the ACV2, by the way. It have been a little complicated, the production of this kit, because for this model it was the first one that we made completely about the body shell. It was a cooperation that I had with an Italian designer, I dare to say, that was loving this car so much like I did, and he made back in time, I think we're talking about nearly now, I guess, in 2020 soon, so I think it's stuff of 5 or 6 years, no more, I think about 8 or 10 maybe years ago, he made a 3D body shell of this car, you know, because the ACV2 was mostly using the central section of the body. This central section was the door and the roof derivated, and the windshield, of course, derivated from the original Delta S4. And the wheelbase was also similar to the Delta S4, but all the rest of the mock-up presented in Turin and presented around was completely another car, was completely different, you know. It was a kind of show car with a special engine that was the evolution of the Delta S4. It was named the Triflux engine. It was incredibly more powerful. I think they really made the Triflux, and some units of the Triflux were racing in Il Climbs, you know. And so they made a part, very few numbers of the motor that have been just used like a racer in Italy. And they were extremely powerful and absolutely delicate engine, because they were very, very easy to explode, you know, without the assistance of the real factory Fiat group following the develop and fixing every time the engine for the future steps, you know. So it was just a test that they did. The model that had been produced was also this one, casted in that gray resin, like the one that I showed you in the video of the 206S Dino, and so it was extremely easy to work. And it's very simple, because I didn't have the time to close the model with the possibility to show up the engine, this rear black hatch. In the rear car, it was a kind of black plexiglass, very, very dark, and inside it should be visible the Triflux, you know, but the Triflux had a completely different shape from the ordinary Delta S4 engine, so it was not possible to make it from that. I wanted to, because I didn't tone the 3D mask, it was just a borrowing that I have from this guy, and I can use it for some time to make a very, very small production of this, as I always say, mostly for myself, because I wanted this object for myself, first of all, and then for a very, very limited numbers of guys that understand and they know really what are we talking about this incredible racer. So if you want to have an ACV2, there are absolutely no other ways to have anything in 124 scale, absolutely anything. There is some stuff in 143, some big stuff in 118, looking more like a toy, honestly, but nothing, like neither a curbside model in 124. And of course, this has been a very, very interesting step in the production of this model, because it was the first attempt that I did using 3D parts. It was long before I started to use Facebook. It was long before I get in touch with the guys that today can produce 3D parts with printers and all the evolution that you know much better than me, that is in progress at today. Inside the kit, I still have one personal copy to show you how it was made, this kit. Was this box, you know, original one, not for sale. So inside the kit, the main part, the main frame was this one, so you had a cockpit, exactly the same scheme of delta is 4 and the dino, you know, and a rear, just a rear frame to present a mock-up of the engine. You know, this was meant to be a curbside model, so it was the intention was to make it closed. This was the dyno for the rear black hatch that in my model I simply polished it completely, made it completely shiny and glossy, and painted in flat black, and it fits over the frame with the main wing. And the most important part is anyway the body shell, because the body shell I think was absolutely taken in the shape and in the dimension of the car. In the I provided inside the box four wheels like this one that are basically the wheels of the Lancia Delta S4. And as seen as in many pictures, because part of the presentation they had a different sprocket. Also the rims inside should be meant to be like a carbon fiber rim, you know, back in time. There is some picture showing them, in the, mostly on the ACV1, so I probably will place that wheel inside the ACV1. And the dimension is anyway the same of Delta S4. I use the street setup, so the street tire and the street rim. And inside you also could find, back in time it was not so easy, absolutely today it could be a photo etched part, you know, photo etched part mostly for the cap filler and engine hooks, and first of all the Lancia logo and the front typical part, you know, of this car, identical to Lancia Delta, Delta S4, and Delta Integrale, Delta Evoluzione, that models. Couple of windshields and the dimes, you know, the dimes to make by your own the transparent parts. You know, I didn't provide a vacuum form because I think it was absolutely not necessary. You know, when you have these kind of frames, it's very easy, it's just enough that you cut in the proper shape and dimension, then you fix little by little with the proper glue, and without making a mess, it's absolutely easy to glue, like in the real car, to glue the glass in this position, and the curving is absolutely little, so you don't have a very curved part like in the Dino that need absolutely a thermoformed part. So you can absolutely easily do it this way. And this is the decals. Also here I just took the few images of the rolling chassis going around Turin in body shops to be painted, to be detailed for Expo and so on. There is some cars that have the red ACV2 and the one with the logo inside, experimental composite vehicle, the typical Martini band on the windshield and the Martini stripes around the body. So it was most around this. The car has been produced in very, very small numbers, you know. I think I still have one or two. I don't know if you are interested in this car. Just as usual, drop me a mail. So because I know I have many contacts with also collectors that took the model anyway, and probably will never buy the car, so I can buy it back. Depends from the request, you know. And that's it. This is it. I think the car is looking like the stuff that we see in picture, absolutely unique item, and despite it was a kind of odyssey to keep it to production this time, mostly for the cooperation with other third parts, but I'm really satisfied with the work, and I think that really looks like an ACV2, amazing group S races from now dead forever Lancia Corse. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next videos.